Today I'm house hunting in the heart of the Alicante countryside. It's a beautiful place with properties set amongst some of the most idyllic olive groves and vineyards in southern Spain. I'm Jasmine Harmon. For more than a decade now, I've been helping people find fantastic homes. Today I'm going to be using all my skills to change the lives of house hunters Vicky and Simon. And it's a case of love.
We're falling in love with it, I think, aren't we?
Yeah.
And hate.
Not an ounce of character.
No, not really.
No.
Meanwhile, I visit this plush property that leaves me speechless.
Wow! Oh my goodness.
And finally, Vicky and Simon face a life-changing decision.
Yeah, we'd like to put an offer in.
Today's house hunters are Vicky O'Grady and Simon Stevenson from Gloucester. They're keen to relocate to the warm climate and laid-back lifestyle of the southern Spanish countryside. Vicky and Simon have been together for 13 years and share a passion for both Spain and their two much-loved greyhounds, Luna and Digby.
Yeah, I love dogs. I'd have another three or four dogs, to be honest.
I'd like to become known as the Mad Dog Lady of Alicante. That would be fine.
Between them, they have seven children and two grandchildren. With Vicky retired for health reasons and Simon having always wanted to live and work abroad, now the kids have all left home, they're ready to turn their dreams into reality and have a budget of £70,000. A 2.5-hour flight from the UK brings you to Alicante, at the heart of southern Spain's Costa Blanca. While a majority of the 5 million UK arrivals to Alicante Airport each year head to the coast, the area inland between the coast and the Sierra de Salinas mountains is a tranquil region home to traditional villages and an authentic Spanish way of life. Alicante has more foreign property owners than any other province in Spain. Properties away from the coast are popular here as they offer an escape from the more touristy locations and... With inland properties up to 50% cheaper than those found on the coast, this area offers some great opportunities to find a real bargain. With a full-time relocation on the cards, I want to catch up with Vicky and Simon to find out more about what they're looking for. Welcome to beautiful rural Alicante, you two. How long have you been thinking about buying a place out here?
For about 10 years, yeah, really, ever yeah, since really. We first started yeah. coming out here. Yeah.
What is it you love about it?
The sunshine, the way of life out here, with the health issues that I've got, the climate, it should be better for me.
What are the health issues?
I have a chronic fatigue condition that does make standing for any period of time quite difficult, but I say very positive.
And work-wise, do you two have any plans?
Currently serving the RAF reserves, working on airfield, so I plan to get a job at Alicante Airport and work out here eventually.
So when you think about the property in Spain that you'd like to have, what do you see?
Well, we see detached. Two bedrooms is the minimum. Lots of outside space, an outside cooking area, perhaps a nice olive grove or something, you know, to the side of the property.
An olive grove, no less.
The whole reason we're doing it, really, is our two lurchers. We have a Saluki cross called Digby and a greyhound called Luna, and they're both rescue dogs.
Oh, how
and
lovely.
And I want somewhere where I can just open a gate and say, there you go for your run.
How much are you going to give me to work my magic?
£70,000 is the maximum.
I would say that the type of property that we're going to look at here, for the budget, there will always be compromises.
That's fine. We understand that. We know that.
We know for the money we've got, we're not going to get a mansion. But if it needs upgrading or is decorating or...
Like a paint or something.
Yeah, we don't mind. That can be done over time.
What colour paint do you like?
Yellow.
Yellow?
The yellow and the terracottas.
I'm very excited to show you some of the properties that we found here, and I'm very hopeful as well, fingers crossed, that we will find you the perfect place. Okay. So let's get started.
All right, brilliant, cheers.
Let's go.
This is a big move for Vicky and Simon and the start of a new life in Spain. So I want to do everything I can to find them that dream property. We're starting the search in Aspe, a pretty town perfectly situated, a 30-minute drive from both the mountains and the coast. It has all the amenities you'd expect, as well as a number of pretty parks and squares, such as this one, Plaza Mayor, dominated by an impressive 17th century basilica.
Now, listen to that, the church bells in the square. You almost can't get more Spanish.
I love it. I'm in love already.
Are you?
Yes, definitely, definitely.
It does got that Spanish feel about it as well. It's really authentic, it's beautiful.
Lots of cafes, restaurants, you've got a couple of big supermarkets. And although it's very busy now with lots of hustle and bustle, in the afternoon it does get really quiet when all the Spanish people go for their siesta.
Well, I will be having a siesta too.
Really?
We will be having our siesta.
Our first property is about a 5-minute drive from the centre of Aspe. Shall we head over and have a look then?
Yes, please.
Although Aspe has become more popular with expats over the last few years, only 8% of the local population are British, which is great for Vicky and Simon, who want that authentic Spanish experience. The town's popularity and proximity to the airport and beaches mean properties here are 15 to 20% more expensive than those in other inland towns. But we've managed to find a property perfect for Vicky and Simon, just outside of the town.
Now, here we are, and we are looking at this property, a 4-bedroom detached house with some lovely yellow paint. What do you think?
Good size.
4 bedrooms.
Four bedrooms. That is nice to think I can get that in my price range.
How do you two feel about this location?
I mean, distance from the main town's good. There's still quite a bit of industrialisation
around
here.
There's a little bit of buildings.
This one's been on the market for about 5 months now. It originally came on at around £83,500. But around 2 weeks ago, the price was reduced and it's now on for just over £70,000.
OK.
Close to budget then?
Yeah. Coming up here, you've got this nice covered terrace area. Yes. You've got this lovely area with the swings.
I like this because
and
it's
nice
shaded.
And shaded.
Yeah, that is nice.
Can you picture the grandkids here?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
definitely.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And.
Swimming
pool.
Yeah.
That looks nice.
I really see this as somewhere, because you've got the 4 bedrooms, that all the family could come together.
Yes, I would love to end up with something with 4 bedrooms. That would be brilliant if it's in the price range.
They seem excited by the size of the property, as well as this terrace, tiled courtyard, and pool. There's also a utility space, outside bathroom, alfresco kitchen, and large rooftop solarium. Inside, the property has a good-sized living room with 4 bedrooms and a compact kitchen.
Here we go, come on in. And wow, what do you think of this?
It's a lot bigger than I thought we would get for the budget, I have to say. It's a nice size.
It is big size, isn't it?
Yeah.
Can you visualise this with all your own furniture?
Yes, I've got my own furniture that I'm bringing over. I have one piece in particular that...
I'm going to pay the removal man to drop and break.
Comes with me wherever I go.
It's a unit, you know, with glass cabinets. I've had it about 30 years and I'm going to make it a family heirloom. I'm going to force one of my children to... I'm going to leave it to one of them in my will and force them to have it.
Layout, you've got bedroom. All your 4 bedrooms are off this main space, plus a bathroom there. We've got a little courtyard area out there. Okay. So if we go through there, we will find the kitchen.
I was going to say, where's the kitchen?
It's quite an unusual layout, but come with me and have a look. So coming out here, you have to go outside to come back in to the little kitchen.
Right.
It's quite little in here. Through that door, you've got a lovely old-fashioned bread oven. Mm.
It is a lovely, lovely house.
How would you feel if I told you there was also an enormous roof terrace?
We'd have to be spending time on there on our own, though, without the dogs. We wouldn't want them jumping off the edges, but...
Well, I suppose we could work that out, though, couldn't we?
Here we go. Now, how do you two feel about having all this extra outside space?
Fantastic space, isn't it?
It's lovely.
Yeah. You could do an awful lot with this.
We've come out for the views.
Have you?
Yeah, as well as, you know, a bit of space for the dogs. We want to be able to look out and not look at big grey buildings.
See, actually, when we first spoke, views weren't mentioned.
We're going to have to change our idea on that, I think. I think we may have to move slightly further away.
Further away.
Right.
To get the views.
I think we perhaps assumed, obviously wrongly, that out here in the mountains and in the secluded inland Alicante, you don't have industrial estates. But of course you do.
Do you two want to have a look at the rest of this, the bedrooms and the other bits and pieces?
No, I don't think it's the property for us. The location is very, very important to us. It's important for the dogs and for us.
So shall we finish up here and head off?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
What a shame. While this property offers Vicky and Simon more space than they'd hoped for, this four-bedroom house on the market for just over £70,000 doesn't have the views they're after. In search of the perfect property, we're heading a further 15 minutes inland to find them a more rural location. But first, I want Vicky and Simon to meet expat Colin Buck, who runs a local charity helping to find and rehome stray dogs. Something I think would interest our dog-loving couple.
Who are these two puppies?
These two we picked up yesterday morning. I've called them Sonny and Cher. And they were just dumped in somebody's garden. So this morning I'm taking them to our charity shop with a view to somebody, hopefully fostering them at least. Big dogs, the older dogs, are a very, very big problem. There are far too many dogs and not enough homes.
The bigger dogs, hopefully. Actually, the older dogs could be something that we would be interested in, and also the fostering.
It's difficult to find people who foster dogs.
Yeah, well. Yeah.
The trouble is with fostering, it's giving them up, isn't it?
Yes.
Well, it looks like Vicky and Simon are already taking on more dogs. The pressure's on to find the perfect house for them and their growing pack.
Coming up, a villa with these amazing views of the Alicante countryside. Today I'm house hunting in the beautiful Alicante countryside, helping Vicky and Simon find their perfect home.
This is a permanent relocation, and Vicky and Simon are looking for somewhere inland to escape the more touristy areas for their budget of £70,000. So far, we've shown them a four-bedroom villa on the edge of Aspe, but they felt the views and surrounding area were not right for them. So, to find a more tranquil setting with views, we've headed a further 15 minutes inland to Los Batistes, where prices are generally 10 to 15% cheaper. But with only 150 homes in Los Batistes, properties here are sought after, especially in Vicky and Simon's price range. So, I'm delighted to have found this two-bedroom bungalow with beautiful gardens.
Now, here's our second property. The outside space here is around three times the size of the last property that we saw. So, first impressions.
I mean, the views, look at the views, spectacular around the back of the house as well.
We're a bit more along the right tracks for the views.
On the right tracks, definitely.
This is what we were looking for, definitely.
The house itself is quite a bit smaller.
Yes, I can appreciate.
It's a two-bedroom, needs a bit of work.
Okay.
You expect that for the money we're paying,
so
that's okay.
We're open-minded.
This one has been on the market for around 18 months, and the price was previously around £83,000, but it's now come down to just over £70,000. The agent thinks there might be a bit of movement in that, and an offer of about £66,000 would be likely to get you the property. Now, we can take a bit of a closer look at the house, the garden, which goes all the way around the back.
Wonderful, wonderful, yes. I've
got my little kitchen area over there.
Yes, he wants the outside kitchen. Yeah. With my house condition, I have to spend a lot of time resting in the day, doing something called pacing. I have to rest for so long before I can continue with an activity. So I want somewhere where I can recharge my batteries and get the most out of it. And I think we might be on the right lines here.
Yeah? Do you think you could do that here?
Yes, I think I could definitely do that here, yes.
Let's go and have a look inside.
Okay.
That's a great first impression. We're definitely moving in the right direction. The property sits at the back of the plot and comes with this large garden filled with mature olive and fruit trees, as well as a garage, outside kitchen and front terrace. Inside, there's a small living room, two good-sized bedrooms, and a kitchen and bathroom that could benefit from some updating.
Come on in, then. Mm. Now, this is your sitting room. As you can see, you don't even need to bring your dresser with you. You've got one here already.
I'll be replacing that. The room is snug. A little bit on the small side, possibly. If I'm honest, I did want something perhaps slightly bigger. May have to sacrifice, go further out into the sticks to get that, but that is an option for us.
We have to think about, obviously, during the day, the dogs need to be in shade and shelter, so they're quite big dogs, and if we're going to foster more dogs, we're going to need a little more inside space, I think, as well.
Yeah.
If you turn into the kitchen there, Simon, size-wise, this is a lot bigger than the kitchen at the last property. You know, it's a little bit dated.
It's usable.
You got quite excited about the little barbecue outside kitchen area.
That's my area.
That's your area. Yeah. So does that mean this inside kitchen is yours?
No, not really.
No, not much of a cook.
Well, I do a little bit, you know.
I'm more of a cook, though, aren't I?
Quite adventurous with what I make.
I made paella from scratch. So, with a lot of fish paella, it was really nice, wasn't it?
So do you think you'd do that outside and maybe invite the neighbours over?
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. Mm.
So the kitchen you're happy with, living room's a bit small. We've got two bedrooms just behind us here, but I want to show you where I think the real potential lies with this property. So follow me. Now, come through.
Thank you.
When we were outside, you may have noticed there's a garage door.
Yeah.
So this is the inside. And what I was thinking is actually this could be a fantastic space.
Yeah.
Depending on what you feel is most needed, a big living space.
Yeah.
You could put an additional bathroom.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, there is potential here.
To do a basic conversion of this space, i.e. roof, plastering, a window, would cost about £1,750.
I mean, I like the land, definitely. The space outside, the kitchen outside is what we want. It's just, I think, I know converting this into a living room would be, I think, too much of a cost.
It's difficult,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It's on the edge.
I'm going to let you two have a look around the rest before you make any decisions about this one.
Yes, please, yeah.
So if you want to head back through and I'll catch up with you afterwards.
Okay. Thank you.
I feel like we're getting a lot closer to what they actually want. They love the outside space. They really like the location. They're a little bit put off by the cost of doing some of the work, but I feel like this place has got fantastic potential.
Oh, this is a good size.
This is nice, isn't
it? Yeah, it is nice. Nice and airy, quite cool. Oh, this is a nice bit of extra space.
Yeah.
But we said we wanted olive trees and we definitely got them.
Yeah,
but
we have, haven't we? Yeah. I think the dogs will... plenty of room to run around out here as well, haven't they?
Vicky and Simon seem to love the outside space at this two-bedroom property, on the market for just over £70,000. But is it big enough inside for both them and their dogs?
Hello.
Hiya.
So, what did you two think of the rest?
The outside for me is perfect.
Yeah.
The inside is probably just too small.
Moving forward from this, then, give me your wish list.
More living space, a little more space inside.
I have got something in mind that might fit the bill.
Okay.
Shall we go and have a look?
Yes. Yeah, let's go, yeah.
Yeah.
I need to find the right balance between indoor and outdoor space. So for our next property, we're heading 10 minutes south to Hondón de los Frailes. A small village of under 1,500 permanent residents, Hondón de los Frailes, has become a hub for expats, with over 50% of the population from overseas. But before we head to the property, I want to take Vicky and Simon to a local olive press, as I know they're keen to have their own olive grove.
This is an olive press where a local gentleman called Juan presses olives into oil. Okay. So I know you said you were keen to have an olive grove, didn't you?
Yes, yes.
Is that because you love olives?
I love olives.
I hate olives.
You hate olives?
Oh, it's disgusting. Most vile tasting thing I think I've ever eaten.
I love olives.
Yes, I can get my own olives made into my own olive oil. The family will be getting my olive oil for Christmas, birthdays, you know.
Well, that's our couple's Christmas presents sorted.
Coming up, see what Vicky and Simon make of the beautiful olive groves at our next property. Vicky and Simon have decided to seize the day and relocate to rural Alicante in beautiful southern Spain.
They have a budget of £70,000 and are looking for enough space for their two rescue dogs and their seven children and two grandchildren to come and visit. So far, we've shown Vicky and Simon two properties. They loved the space on offer at this large four-bedroom villa with a pool, but felt the views were not what they were hoping for. And while they loved the beautiful gardens at this two-bedroom bungalow in Los Batistas, they ruled it out because they felt the property was just too small. So the search continues, and I'm hoping the next property will strike the perfect balance, giving them the inside and outside space they require, alongside the views that they crave. We've come to Hondón de los Frailes, a small village 45 minutes drive from the coast. The average price for a two-bedroom property here is between £90,000 and £100,000, way over Vicky and Simon's budget of £70,000. So we're delighted to have found this property, which could be within their reach.
Here we are then. As you can see, you know, you've got beautiful countryside all around you. What do you think on first impressions?
Well, it's yellow, so that's a good start.
It's yellow. Indeed it is.
I did say four bedrooms, all three.
You've got four bedrooms.
No.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Okay. And a little bit more indoor space.
Lots more space, living space.
Nice big, doesn't have to be olives, but, you know, nice big space with some trees in.
You've got olive trees.
There's so many things we've asked for.
The views were really important, weren't they, at the first property?
And the seclusion, which we've... Oh, God,
I mean, come on. I mean, you're looking down into the valley. It's amazing.
So have I done all right?
You've done very, very well, Jasmine. You've done very well.
Wait, shall I tell you the price? The asking price is just over £70,000. Yeah. What would the dogs think of this?
Oh, I think they'd be well impressed. Yeah, it looks lovely with the four bedrooms. It's not just the dogs. I mean, the family. It offers more scope to have family out.
What do you think, Simon?
Just listen to that.
It's lovely, isn't it?
Amazing.
Well, let's crack on then and have a look inside. Yeah?
Okay.
Yeah?
Can't wait.
Well, I don't think that could have gone any better. Outside, the property has a wraparound paved area perfect for their dogs, Luna and Digby. And three terraced areas filled with almond, fig, olive and peach trees. Inside this well-proportioned property, there's an enclosed front terrace that leads to a large living room. Off this are two good-sized bedrooms, while a corridor with a further two bedrooms and the bathroom leads to the good-sized kitchen at the rear of the property.
Come on through now. Space for your dresser.
My dresser, it can go there, Simon.
Oh, can we just stop talking about this dresser? I can't believe it's in our price range, to be honest. It's just perfect. This room's a lot bigger than the last one.
Yes. Obviously, you know, you're going to want to do some updating. You bring your own furniture and your own style to it. This is going to be quite an emotional move, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, it will be if I find the right place. And I'm feeling as if I may have found it.
It's got the views, it's got the location, it's got the space, it's got... Well, it's just got everything at the moment.
Yeah. You both look a bit shell-shocked, I have to say. What's going on?
Well, we're falling in love with it, I think, aren't we,
Lou? Yeah. Can we see the rest of it?
Can we see the rest of it?
Oh, OK, I've teased you for long enough. Let's go through. So coming through, you've got a single bedroom there.
Nice.
That's your bathroom through there. But have a look at this kitchen.
Oh, it's huge.
Wow, this is massive. This is
isn't
really
it?
Big, yeah. It's not like the previous property where it was a bit 70s. But
yeah. I like it. I want to keep the traditional Spanish sort of rustic feel to the property. Mm. I wouldn't change this room. At all.
I mean, this dream has been, 10 years in the making?
Yeah.
And now you're like...
We are.
This close.
Yeah. I'm blown away.
So should we go and have a look at the outside space? Because I know that's really important for the dogs.
Yeah, let's go.
Great.
So out the back here, let me know what you're thinking about this. You've got a lovely orchard back here. Look, peaches on the tree there. And as well as the almonds, the olives, all the rest of the land that you've got to the side.
With all these fruit trees, I'd never have to go to the supermarket, would I? I could be self-sufficient, live off the land. Yeah, no, it's...
You've done a good job here.
I might have peaked you early.
I think so.
Do you want to go and have a good old nosy around the rest?
Yes, please, if you can.
Come and find me afterwards and we'll have another chat then.
Great.
Cheers, thank you.
It seems like this place is absolutely perfect for them, and I think it's going to be quite hard to beat, but I'm going to give it a try.
Is this the biggest room, I wonder? It's a lovely size.
Put some wardrobes
there. Yeah, we've got bits we want to bring from home, haven't we? Bedrooms, so it would all fit in here. This is all still ours, love.
I know, I can't believe we've got all of this here.
Yeah. I can't work out which is which with the trees. Which is olive and which is fruit.
Well, the olive ones are down there.
All right. Have you counted how many olive trees
there
are?
There's about six or seven, I can see.
Is there? All right, OK.
I'm not sure what the others
are. We're going to have a bit of olive oil then.
It looks like we finally have a contender. Vicky and Simon have fallen in love with the space inside and out at this rural property. It's on the market for just over £70,000, but is it time to get the champagne on ice?
The burning question for me is, where do we go from here?
Yes. If you can match this...
You seem to have made up your minds, but I do love a challenge. And there are some options out there that I think are really worth a look. So let's go and have a look.
OK.
It feels like my job is done, but I'm determined to try and find Vicky and Simon something even better. So we're heading 10 minutes north to the traditional sleepy Spanish village of La Romana. There are far fewer expats here, with just over 20% of the population from overseas. The village has a handful of amenities, from cafe restaurants to a baker's and a weekly indoor market, so I've brought Vicky and Simon to the centre of the village to give them a taste of rural Spanish life.
I think that this location could suit you.
Yeah.
The property that we're going to have a look at is just outside the town, because I know you don't want to be right in the centre of everything.
No.
Every August, they have their big fiesta.
Oh, lovely.
Where everyone comes out into the streets and the whole community get involved, and it's a real party atmosphere.
Great.
So if you've got, you know, the grandchildren over here during the school holidays...
My birthday is August,
Well, maybe you could have a big...
big
joint
fiesta.
Celebration. Yeah, lovely.
In La Romana, prices have stabilised over the last 6 months, and homes around Vicky and Simon's budget are selling fast, especially those in good condition. We've lined up this property that's been fully renovated in the last 12 months, but if they like it, they'll have to move quickly.
Now, here we are. This is our next property. Everything inside is brand spanking new. You've got a lovely area of land all the way down here. So you've got a little gate there, direct access. So that could be ideal for the dogs. The olive grove down at the bottom is also yours. Now, what do you think of this property?
OK. How many bedrooms?
It's two bedrooms.
Okay. Yeah.
This one is quite a bit under budget. It's on the market for around £59,500.
Wow, OK, that's quite cheap.
OK.
So that is partly why I thought this might be an interesting option.
Yeah.
I'm not sensing a great deal of enthusiasm with this one, but are you open to having a look
inside? Yeah, we'll have a look inside.
Are you curious at all to see what you get for less than £60,000?
Yeah.
With all this land?
Yeah. We'll take a look inside.
Do you know what? I always knew that this one was going to be a little bit of a gamble for them. I'm just worried I might have pushed them a bit too far.
The outside space is arranged over three areas, a long driveway leading down to the property with its fenced garden, and then a large separate olive grove. As this property was once a small casita or summer house, it's all on one level. You enter straight into the main open-plan living and kitchen space, off of which there are two bedrooms and a large bathroom.
I think this is obviously the living room, dining room and kitchen all
in
one as well.
Oh, it's very modern.
No, it's a bit too small as well.
If somebody was looking for a holiday home, I think this could really be a terrific project for them. I think we were spoiled with the last property, weren't we, because that had a real Spanish feel.
Yeah, I must admit, it's quite square and dull and... Yeah, no, it's not like the last house we saw.
Oh, yeah.
It's a nice bedroom.
Pleasant enough room.
Yeah, still holiday home feel though, isn't it?
Not an ounce of character.
No, not really.
Yeah.
That's not the reaction I was hoping for from this fully renovated two-bedroom casita on the market below Vicky and Simon's budget at just under £60,000.
Oh, hi, Jasmine.
Hi.
Hi.
Oh, smiles.
No,
what
not
did
really.
You think?
Oh. Just to see you, that's all. There seems to be no room in there. You've got, seems to have the dining room, a kitchen table in the kitchen, but no living room.
Would make a lovely holiday home for somebody.
Really?
It's been done very well. Lovely kitchen area, lovely shower bathroom, but it's a holiday home. I've got to say, it's got zero character for me. Mm. So it's a categoric no.
So we're still at the yellow house, aren't we?
100%, yes.
So,
final one.
I know. I'm feeling the pressure now a little bit because I always like to have a couple of contenders in the running. We've got one. Definite. Yeah. So let's go and see if we can see what this last one has to offer.
Coming up, my final property puts Vicky and Simon in a spin.
Ooh, it definitely has thrown a spanner in the works, hasn't it, this
it
one
has a bit,
so
this
far?
One. Yeah.
Today I'm helping Vicky and Simon find their dream home here in Spain's Alicante region.
This is a massive move as it's a permanent relocation. On their budget of £70,000, they need somewhere that's perfect for themselves, their two dogs and for visiting family. So far we've shown Vicky and Simon four properties, but there's just one contender. This yellow four-bedroom home that comes complete with a fenced garden and three-tier orchard. Coming up, a new challenger enters the race.
I'm really in a pickle now, I've got to say.
But But first, I'm heading to the outskirts of Alicante to take a look around a luxury property that's currently on the market for €1 million. This 18th century villa has been fully renovated by its current owner, an American shoe designer who splits her time between Alicante and New York. And it's all about her eclectic mix of opulent interior design and luxury style. I'm here to meet estate agent Pedro Lloret, who's going to show me round.
Wow! Oh my goodness.
This is one of the most impressive living rooms I have never seen in my life.
This is quite different, isn't it? I almost don't know what to look at first. It looks like there are things that have been collected from all different parts of the world and brought into this one place. Wow. It's just amazing. Like, you see all the
that's the
original features, but then combined with all the bright colours.
The kitchen was made specially by hand in England. This is an English kitchen.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And what's this down here?
It's here for her dogs.
Oh, hello. You just come to say hello as well. So these are the dogs' beds under here.
Yeah, that's right. That's the bed of the dogs.
So these dogs live in luxury as well.
Yeah, everybody here lives in luxury.
By far the most unique feature of this property is located in an outhouse and is dedicated to a subject close to the property owner's heart.
Oh, wow! This is going to be a big attraction, isn't it, for a lot of people, mainly of the female persuasion.
She has been buying shoes for the last 40, 50 years all over the world.
So there must be some really special shoes amongst this collection.
This is a Chinese shoe and belongs to a Chinese princess. It's like around 300 years old.
This is a first for me. I have never seen a house with a shoe museum thrown in, and certainly not one like this. I mean, this is spectacular.
Well, I better get my running shoes on and get back to the search with our house hunters, Vicky and Simon. We currently have a clear front runner. To beat it, I'm going to have to strike that perfect balance between indoor and outdoor space. So we're heading 30 minutes northwest of Alicante to Monóvar. And I wanted to show Vicky and Simon Parc de l'Ouest, a beautiful Gaudi-inspired park with tropical gardens and an open-air amphitheatre.
Now, I really wanted to impress you with, obviously, our last property and last location. This is a wonderful place. It's absolutely huge. Waterfalls, you've got a sculpture park, and throughout the summer they have theatre shows and live concerts for adults and for children.
Oh, lovely. This is lovely. I can't wait to get my grandkids here.
I know!
There's so much to do inland as well.
Yeah.
And it's just, you never dream of the things that are around.
I think a lot of people are missing out, aren't they? Not coming
inland. I think so.
Let's not tell everyone.
I was going to say, but don't tell anyone. Keep that a secret.
While Parc de l'Ouest is clearly impressive, the centre of Monóvar is also bursting with Spanish charm. 70% of properties here are detached villas in the outskirts, and I hope they'll love the one that I have lined up.
Here we are then. As you can see,
it does have
a swimming pool. The land here is pretty much the same size, actually slightly bigger than at the Yellow House. So what are you two thinking? Is this giving the Yellow House some competition?
We love the Yellow House, but I think it's going to give it some competition. Why? We're very interested around.
It's also not only the pool, but it's got a nice veranda area here with plenty of shade.
Yes. This one is actually on the market a little over budget.
Okay.
For just under £73,000. But as far as the agent has indicated, she would be willing to come down a little bit from 73,000 down to around 68,500.
Okay.
Which brings it again within reach.
Brilliant.
Which might give you even more of a dilemma.
It will.
So come on, you can see what a nice covered terrace. You can see a bit more of the land from here as well. What do you think?
Actually, this bench is way too tempting. I think we need to sit down and take it in.
Well, why not?
It's a long day.
Yes. Can you see yourself sitting here then?
I didn't think, after we saw the yellow property, that anything else would give us that feel.
And you could sit and look at the grandkids playing in the pool.
Well, it's more of an open space for the dogs without having to fence bits off.
Ooh, it definitely has thrown a spanner in the works, hasn't it,
Yeah.
What a great start. This four-bedroom villa has a large fenced garden filled with fruit and olive trees, as well as a pool. Off the large covered terrace, you enter straight into the living and kitchen space. Off this are the bedrooms and a large bathroom.
Oh, here we go then, come on in. Mm-hmm. It's got a different sort of feel to it, hasn't it, compared to your current favourite.
They are comparing so close. Mm. They're so close. But I do like this space. It's plenty for the bits that we know we're going to need.
Yeah, I like it. I don't know if it's comparing as much to the other house for me.
Really?
Yeah, I'd probably need to see the rest of it, but it's not wowing me as much as the other
house. It's not wowing you as
not
much. Well,
not my inside, so.
And actually, I mean, I know the kitchen there was huge, wasn't it? And you wouldn't have needed to change that. And the kitchen here, you've got an open plan kitchen, so it's just separated by this little arch. What do you think of this?
Yeah, well, I mean, it's nice. I don't think it's as nice as the other one, but no, it's still a workable kitchen.
Oh, it sounds like you two are really in trouble here, because
there may be some discussions this evening.
Two bedrooms here. These are the larger of the two bedrooms. As you can see, you've got a double bed and bunk beds.
Yes, this is a good size room, isn't it?
Yeah, they're a good size.
Yeah.
They're a similar size to the yellow property as well. So,
He's digging his heels in,
larger.
I'm trying to compare the two.
So I'm visualising this with me putting my stamp on it and that large veranda outside with a swimming pool and the area where the dogs can run from the veranda. That's got me in, and I'm really in a pickle now, I've got to say.
Take five to chat together and see what you're both thinking.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I'll come and find you outside.
All right.
Okay, thanks.
Cheers, thanks. All
right. Well, this one really has given them a dilemma, which is almost what I was hoping to do. Now it looks like there are two properties in the running.
It is quite big, and I think whereas the yellow house needed it almost straight away replaced, I think we could probably live with this.
No, you're right. No, I agree with you.
What?
All right, just this one room.
Well.
Oh no, this veranda is nice.
It is nice.
And having that pool's nice.
It is. I can see myself sat here, and I like the idea of the dogs, the direct access with the dogs.
So for Vicky, we have another contender. But has this four-bedroom villa on the market for just under £73,000 won over Simon?
Hi, Jasmine.
Hi. Oh,
no,
look at you.
You've really done it with this one. I think it's got real potential. You've done too good a job, Jasmine.
The outside is more appealing to me, but there's still quite a bit of work to do.
Well, I'm really, really pleased that, you know, that you have liked two of the properties, enough to be in this situation. I'm sure once you've had time to digest everything and go through it, a winner will emerge. So shall we head back to the hotel?
Yes, please.
Yeah, let's go.
Thanks.
If you want any more information on any of the properties featured on today's show, go to aplaceinthesun.com/programmes. We've now shown Vicky and Simon five properties for their budget of £70,000, but there are just two left in the running. The yellow house that both Vicky and Simon instantly fell in love with, on the market for just over £70,000, as well as this four-bedroom villa that has the added bonus of a large front terrace and pool, on the market for just under £73,000, which Vicky also loved, but Simon wasn't so sure about. After a night of discussion, I can't wait to find out what they've decided to do.
So have you managed to make a decision then between the yellow house and the final property that we saw that had pretty much everything, including the swimming pool?
Yes, we did.
Have you?
I got my way.
You got your way?
I got my way.
I'll never guess what happened.
For the first time ever. I think I was right, so yeah. Yeah, we'd like to put an offer in on the yellow house.
That is fantastic news.
Yeah.
I mean, I know that one was really top end of your budget, and they have said that, you know, there's not really a great deal of extra room for negotiation.
What sort of offer are you thinking about making?
We are going to see if they might just take a little bit less than the full asking price. Shall we try 68,000?
That sounds a reasonable offer to me, and the fact that you are cash buyers may well persuade them. So, shall I make the call then?
Yeah, go on, do it.
Oh my gosh, this is so exciting. Morning, Francisco. I've got some fantastic news for you. Vicky and Simon would like to make an offer on the beautiful yellow house that we showed them. They would like to offer £68,000. I know it's a little bit below the asking price, but Vicky and Simon, they're cash buyers. They're ready to move very quickly. They really love the house. Thank you very much, Francisco. We will be waiting for your call. Thank you. Bye-bye. Ooh, okay, he's going to phone them now.
Okay.
And see what they say. Fingers crossed.
Let's see how it goes.
Let's say they come back with the counteroffer, or they come back and say, sorry, we want the full asking price. What's your plan?
We would pay full asking.
Would you?
Yeah, but maybe if they would let us get to 69, if we could meet in the middle a little bit. That's sort of the plan with the 68.
Yes,
if they didn't take that, we are half hoping they maybe come back to 69.
Fingers crossed.
We would be happy to take.
Here we go. Hello, Francisco. Okay. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Okay, go on then. Give it to us.
So they've come back with a counteroffer.
Okay.
They have said they would accept just under £68,500.
Oh, brilliant.
That's great.
I think that's a great deal.
I'm very grateful for them doing that, actually.
Yeah, we've got
so
it.
That's it?
Oh, yes.
We've done it. Oh, sweetheart.
We got it.
We've done it.
All right. You should do this.
How are you feeling, Vicky?
Great, really. Emotional, but absolutely over the moon, aren't we?
Oh, it's just a new life, isn't it? It's a new start. So, yeah, I just can't wait for it.
Oh, well, congratulations.
Thank you.
And keep me posted. I hope everything runs really smoothly. I'm sure it will.
Yeah. Well, I think it's been a successful trip to Spain, hasn't it?
It certainly has, yeah.
Cheers.
Cheers. Salud.
I could not be happier for Vicky and Simon. They've been dreaming about this move for such a long time, and it's finally come true. I wish them the very best of luck, and I'm sure that they and the dogs will be very happy here in Spain.
And the good news is Vicky and Simon have now paid their deposit and are hoping to complete their purchase in the coming weeks.
Thank you.